Hey guys, how's it going? It's Adama Sanguin and welcome back to Oberlin Station. So today I'm actually going to be working on this security wall. Originally it was just going to be a standard junk wall, but because of the little sitting areas, it's a nice little place down below where they can have some tea perhaps. Okay, probably not tea, but anyway, I might put actually another guard station down below. So first one here, second one over there, and then there will be maybe one down here. But once we get that in, let's go ahead and get these little wall pieces up in here. I love these. These are probably my favorite set. I love these little wood walls here. These ones I used them just recently over in Oberlin Station. They almost look like privacy screens, so I have used them for that. I believe Mad Rocks has actually made some adjustments, and I did half of these, which was pretty nifty. But anyway, yeah, you can use them to block off bedrooms. So we'll get this in here. I am going to be using a lot of pillar glitch in this part of the video. Also want to apologize to those that wanted to see the ugly shack that I was going to build on the corner. So now, yeah, we have a ugly shack on the border and then ugly shack on the corner. So sort of a theme there, I think. But anyway, yeah, I apologize to those that wanted to see that. I actually was actually very sad that I did delete that part of the video. I thought nobody was on Twitter at the time that I posted, or that nobody actually cared. And then, of course, don't you know how things go? If you get impatient, people actually will like to give their the advice you're looking for. If I would have just kept my mouth shut, or would have kept my ears open. But anyway, once we get this little piece in here, I really like how this little part turned out here, because this, I was able to actually get it almost perfect to make it look like the little slats there. So almost like one piece, and you know what we do. So yeah, once we get this little end cap in here, this is going to be a nice little sitting area. And the rain eventually does stop, and I was hesitant to upload this part of the video, because you guys, I've said how I feel about rain. But yeah, it's... I love the rain, but I don't like how it looks in the video, because it tends to make things either a bit too dark or, well, anyway. So yeah, I like that. Little chickens, these things, don't you love free range chicken? They kind of go wherever they want. Yeah, if you guys haven't seen the tweets that I put out, I do update Twitter quite often with little photos here and there, sometimes a little video, just whatever I happen to have on hand, and sometimes I have to remember. But so once again, I want to apologize for getting ahead of myself and getting anxious getting rid of that video, because again, I thought nobody wanted to see it. Little did I know. But yeah, so once we get this little piece in here, it... turned out really well. I just love everybody that's shown all their videos on YouTube, and now there's so much of the stuff that we take for granted, you know, from the simple pillar glitch, you know, the Wi-Fi glitch. Now we know more about that. All you guys that have done those know that there can be potential issues for some of those, and sometimes it's a good idea to not do it. Yeah, I was really surprised in how easy this little half wall was to get in there. I didn't have to glitch it or anything. Although I do really want to glitch these chickens into the ground, because, yeah, they kept getting in the way. Cluck, 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 cluck. Yeah, you guys know I love my lighting, so I love putting them down low, because just the little shadows that the, even the grass, the little stones put off, it just has a little something-something that it does. You guys have seen me use this before. This is going to be a grenade screen. It's going to go on the front of the this little corner piece here, and you guys might have seen the video that I did called This House. Old video, you know, gotten better since then, but the design still holds up for the most part. Sometimes we can take those little things that are still effective and add them in. Anyway, yeah, this, and I totally spaced it, and I'm glad I did that video, because I wouldn't have remembered to switch to the ladder, because the pillar cannot get it that close, but the ladder can. So it was kind of funny that, you know, again, even sometimes we teach ourselves certain things as we go. I'm glad I made my own videos on YouTube. Voila. So, once we're gonna... Darn you, get up there, chicken. Anybody feel like having some chicken? I mean, I don't eat meat, but you know, you guys can if you want to. The yeah, little half piece here. Yeah, this one was a little bit of a pain in the butt to get because, again, any kind of scrapping mods that you're using, they can affect your pillar glitching, how far you can up and down the little pieces here. But not so bad when you're doubling the speed, and when you're actually building, you probably don't even pay attention. But yeah, pretty awesome. Well, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for this half, guys. Again, once I get this second half, or this second wall in here, I'm going to put up a couple of lights, and then we'll have a brief intermission, and I'll jump to the second video portion, or the second half of this video, which I already recorded and commentated on. So once again, I apologize for not getting the ugly little shack done for you guys, but there will be some pictures at the end of this video of how it turned out, and some shoutouts. I am Adama Sanguin. I'll see you in the next one. I love you guys. Spalding's weapons and tack. This idea is basically based off of the ones that you see in Grand Theft Auto for those that have played the game. If not, you guys may have seen a couple of videos that Cordless 7 did where you combine, or not combine, but use these different pre-made buildings that come in USO. At least that's where I got these from. And this one is actually going to be the Cola Cars Arena, which is available only if you have the Nuka-Cola part for USO, and the I believe the standard Diamond City shack here is available in base game USO core components. But I think it turned out really awesome. I really appreciate it. Really, at nighttime has a lot. You know, you guys know I love doing my lighting, and I think that's of course where this actually shines. Now, originally I did think of putting a bed back here in the back, which is why I moved it out. But in the end, I decided to push it forward a little more. Up here on top, I did have this bit sticking out, which I thought would be really nice for a display. I wasn't quite sure what to actually put in here. In the end, we'll actually be putting in some just some oil lamps, just get something standard. I've been trying not to use too many electrical lights, just because, again, they can bog down your games with all the different pieces. So what we actually are using here, these are actually in USO as well, not the farm pieces, but the floor panels here, those are actually in USO's integrated. Those are part of the vault flooring under stone, the reskin stone, or concrete, excuse me, reskin concrete. So these, once we move these out of the way and get up here, we can just snap them right together. Doesn't take much if I can grab the correct one. There we go. All right, now I want to put in what I thought about doing originally is I was going to put in these little wooden railings just to give it that nice rustic feel, but I didn't like how much separation there was, and it was just too plain, because I do want to put in some nice neon lights, and if you get too many spaces in between, it's a good bet that you're going to get your neon lights. So there's your tip for the day. Neon lights can be a pain in the butt if you have any spaces or anything popping out. And once I find that good little spot where I got these oil lamps out of the first time, yeah, so far so good. This went together pretty quick. I think it took about 3 or 4 hours, which isn't bad considering I've never used these pieces before. Well, the Cola Cars Arena I've used in a couple of builds. I used that over in my other build. I can't remember the name of. So once I get these neon lights up here, I'll skip ahead a little bit, and then you can just basically see the finished version. I did have to make one more adjustment there just because the roof was a little out of alignment. But yeah, pretty awesome. Yeah, look at that. It's pretty good. I just wanted to make sure it wasn't poking out there. Now, obviously, you'll notice here that I'm calling it Weapons and Things based off of a design that No Respawns had done. But I didn't want to use the same name, but I did like the name, you know, Weapons and Things. Because I believe his store actually had both weapons and junk sales. But once we get this little walkway in here, that's pretty much going to finish it up. And had to move the crops field there, so I'm actually not going to be using that. So I've got other plans, which I can't show you because that's going to be in the main tour when I'm actually done with this place. But that part is completely finished. Well, I think you guys are going to really appreciate how that turned out. So yeah, old school pillar glitch these up there in place. These are just kind of a placeholder just so that I could snap my not foundations, but my little stairway, my little stair steps in here. But again, good little trick here. So once you get it lined up, the nice thing about using the Diamond City Shack is it's very squishy, very forgiving. I was going to put in an extra piece of walkway just because I didn't like how ugly that left-hand corner is, because you do have to sink the Diamond City Shack because it sits very high, and I'm glad I watched that video that Cordless 7 did, because otherwise I wouldn't have known that I need to cover those up. And also, before I go, I wanted to apologize for those people that did want to see me building the ugly little shack, because I did like it, but a couple other people on another format asked for this. So I do apologize. Please, guys, don't be mad at me. I am Adama Sanguine. I love you all. I'm out.